I'm Margie, and you're back in Marjorie's kitchen today, and I'm doing another episode in a series of cake decorating and icing recipes that I've been putting up online, because I just wanted to do, you know, offer you a lot of different options of things that you can do. I just put a buttercream recipe up, and I use that icing to ice this cake. This is a three-layer cake, which I'm going to decorate for you in another video, but this video shows you how to ice this cake. So I'll be back in a second to show you how to get started. I froze my cakes. What I do is, after I bake them, I let them cool, and I'll freeze them. I'll wrap them very well in some plastic wrap. And then when I'm ready to use them, I'll take them out, let them soften a little bit. And because this cake is a little, well, this is pretty good, but just remember, every time you put another layer on a cake, this little area that goes down is going to collect frosting. So sometimes when you ice the cake, you'll see little bulges if you're not real careful about having your cakes pretty flat. And when the cakes are frozen, you see they're pretty easy to handle. So all I do is, you can do this. I don't really recommend it because you can cut yourself. This is a nice serrated, like a bread knife. You can cut the top off with that. Or because they're frozen, you could never do this with a cake that wasn't frozen. Now I'm not pushing down on the cake. I'm just kind of holding it in place. Let's go ahead. Now I think I've done these cakes here. I had a three-layer cake. Okay, now I have paper on the back. See how easy they are to handle? See, there's still going to be a little bit of an opening there, but it won't be too bad. Because I did cut some off. See, there's the paper there still. So I can kind of show you what it will look like, all right? All right, so we're gonna get started. So you want your turntable to be something, if you're using a Lazy Susan, something that you really can put food on, because you're going to want to start by putting a little bit of icing on your board, okay? Because you want to be able to hold, you want the cake to stay down. So you'll take your first layer and you're just going to lay it down, because I'm going to be able to pick this up off of here with the spatula and put it down on my board in a little while. As a matter of fact, what I can do right now is take my board and put a little bit of icing right down on the board, because you also want to do that later on so the cake doesn't slide. All right, so of course you want to remember to take your papers off, and you can just toss those and get rid of everything as you're working. Okay, I'm going to start with this round one, because this one I like to use for the sides. So we'll start with this round one. Because it's an offset spatula, meaning that it bends, it's a little bit easier to get your thumbs under, you see, when you're working. And that other one is older, it's sort of before. It's before offset spatulas. Okay, so now this is a real buttercream icing made with real butter, okay? So you don't need a ton of icing, because it's very sweet. I mean, you never really need a ton of icing, but because this icing is sweet, I really don't like to put a ton. So you want the icing to come out just a little bit beyond the edge. Okay, and you'll take your next layer, and you want to look at your cake. You turn it, and you look, you get down, and you look to see where the highest point is of the cake, or the lowest. There's my lowest point right here, and then I'm going to look at this one and find my lowest point. I hate it when they're perfect. There's a low point right there, I think. I'm not sure if it's because of the paper, but it looks like that's a low point. Okay. So we'll take that paper off. Don't forget that. And you put the high point, actually, with the low point. And you notice I put the cake upside down. Okay, so again, you do the same thing. I really can't tell. So it's upside down again. You do want to make sure also that your cake is lined up this way, okay? Because when you go to ice the outside, now all my pans are the same. I will tell you that this does, for some reason, it's coming out further. So when I'm done, I probably will cut that. What I think I'm going to do is stop here, and I'm going to cut some of the cake away from the sides because it is, I'm just going to put this down here. I'm going to cut a little bit off, and I'm cutting toward me, but you really want to be careful not to cut yourself, okay? And one other little trick that you can do when you are icing is with the slower you go, the smoother the icing, especially when you go around the sides, okay? When you get all your icing on. All right, when you get your icing on and you go around the cake the last time. I'm not adding so much more ice in here. Right? It's just that now this icing is, first of all, I have my cake covered. See how when I pulled, it's, if you go slower, it'll be smoother looking. I always thought I'd be a good plasterer for a wall. But at first it doesn't matter so much, so just go ahead and go around. I'm trying to get it down to the bottom too. Now, if you're going to decorate with a tip, cake decorate your cake. Okay, at the end, you can certainly not worry so much about the bottom being perfect. Okay. And I kind of, that's this, see why you need a turntable? All right, so I can really get that up against the cake. And going slow is a trick. I learned that when I used to work as a cake decorator from one of the well-seasoned decorators. Okay, and then at the top, when you do the top, you just bring your spatula in like this and go around the edge and go slow again. Oop, I don't want to go too fast. Right, and the edge doesn't have to be perfect if you're going to put a small decoration across the top. Right. Sometimes I put it right on my hand. I'm a bad girl when I do that. Okay. So just remember, bring your tool very slowly. Now sometimes, and I could show you, since I have this cake and I have this icing left over, I'll go ahead and show you what you can do if you want to have those, which I actually like. And if you're not going to, if you're going to put nuts or something on the very top of your cake or the sides of your cake and so forth, and you don't want to, or say you're not going to write, you're making a whipped cream cake or something, you can put your icing down. Okay, but you have, it looks nice there, okay? So go back and just dig a hole, as I say, like that. And you can even push it off of the side. All right? Come back this way. All right? And then you have, you can do this too if you see it's coming too far off. All right? All righty. So then what you want to do is take a spatula and remove this over. here. This is a nice high cake, okay? And you're going to want to, you have your icing on your board, okay? So we'll take this off. And we're going to just slide this underneath the cake. And we're going to pick up the cake, and don't be afraid of your cake. Cake's not going to do anything to you, trust me. All right? Bring it up, slide your hand under as far as you can. Use the tips of your fingers to pick up the cake. All right? No, how can I do this? Find the board. You can always move your cake a little bit. Okay? Later. Try to find your center. And there you go. Always clean off your, if you make those kind of marks. And your cake just come back down here with a clean spatula and just kind of slowly go very slow, because if you don't at this point, because the icing is drying, you're going to tear your cake. I took a look at the bottom of the cake and I wanted to fix up a few things. So I cleaned off my turntable. And I started to fix it up a little bit. It doesn't look too bad, okay, but I just want to do a few little things. And the icing has gotten a little bit harder. So if you want to go back and fix something, you need to go very, very slowly, okay? That's imperative, that you go very slowly to fix. All right, because then you'll definitely not pull that cake. Not pull the cake so much as pull the icing. You know, the icing really, this buttercream, because it isn't made with Crisco, and I mean, it's made with the real butter. So you can go like, that's got a lot of lines if you really want to make it perfect. Just do the slow thing. Push against the cake. You can get rid of a few lines. All right, now if you want to fill in, like right down there, you want to put icing right where you're going to put it on your spatula. Okay, come in here with it and just press it against your board and fill it in like that. Okay, I'm an expert at fixing things. All right, so I can go all the way around the bottom. I don't always like to decorate, I mean, put the borders on. I think cakes are gorgeous without them if they're iced nicely. So I will see you again in another video. I'm going to decorate this cake a little bit. I have some interesting decorations to put on it. Okay, well, we'll see you soon. Bye.